The Disability Rights Unit in Potchefstroom created the What I Wish My Lecturers Knew project. This project aims to raise awareness on how teaching and learning spaces can contribute to students with disabilities either feeling alienated or included. Here's what four students with disabilities wish their lecturers knew.
I am Genevieve Kruiser. I am a second year BA Law with Psychology student, and I have retinopathy of prematurity, which has resulted in my being completely blind.
Hello, my name is Johannes Letea. I'm a student in Northwest University. I'm studying Bachelor of Arts in Psychology and Evaluation. I was involved in a car accident and results in traumatic brain injury, so I consider it as an intellectual disability.
I'm Miral Hon. I'm a second year student for education. I study information technology. And I'm diagnosed with dyslexia.
Hi, my name is Mpumele Longoso. I am a third year LLB student, and my disability is cerebral palsy ataxia. As a person with a physical disability, I am constantly facing academic challenges, and one of them, I'd say, is these pop-up quizzes that are mandatory to see your progression. With those, you only have a limited time. And for someone like me, that limited time doesn't allow me to finish the pop quiz.
Normally in exams, the question is phrased where they give students a sketch and you have to label the parts and then give their functions. So I could not do that because I could not see the sketch, and it was quite challenging to find ways around that so that I could still complete the assessments the same as other students.
Like most often I experience concentration problem in classroom. As the lecture session takes 1 hour 15 minutes, and I can only concentrate for at least 45 minutes and take breaks. So sometimes I get behind with the content because I lack concentration and I need to rest. My brain needs time to access everything and put everything in place.
So in the beginning of my first year, it was really strange. This is a whole new world of studying. I don't know how to study yet, and I don't have my concessions yet. So now I have to find a new world of studying, find the help I need.
I overcame this challenge by reaching an agreement with my lecturers whereby they adapted the questions so that they would ask me what is the function of this specific part of the brain rather than giving me a sketch. So it just faced that I needed a different question paper where the questions were adapted, and then I could answer the question.
And solution that I found with the pop-up quizzes is just asking the lecturer, ma'am, sir, can you be a bit lenient, grant me extra time, or grant me, rather take it away and give me something else that will count the exact same.
The lecturers made me feel supported and included by, at the end of the study unit in lecture room, the lecturers been doing quiz or maybe group discussion in class, so that helped me or supported me or made me feel included in the study unit or study module outcome.
To be supported by your lecturers, you need to inform them of that you're disabled, you have this condition. So each year I make it a point to tell any of, if I have a new lecturer, this is my situation.
Just say that after class, come to me if you have like a disability, or that I can maybe teach the class in a different manner. I think that will help a lot.
What I wish lecturers would knew about students with disabilities, that students with disability, they require more time to study. They don't get to study like other students.
I would ask that they not assume, because not every disability is the same, and not everyone that's been diagnosed with the exact same disability faces the exact same challenges. So one thing Donna's team asked me what I need, asked me how you can accommodate me.
I wish my lecturers would just know that we're not lazy, we're just different. And they're not stupid, we're just a bit slow, but we will always get there.
In order for lecturers to be more inclusive and supportive, I think it's important for them not to shy away from talking to students and having open communication with them, asking them what they can do, how they can make things easier, because I think often people do not know how to approach students with disabilities, and then it leads to sort of a distance on both sides if there isn't open communication. So I think if you can openly talk to your lecturers and they can openly talk to you, then you guys will more easily be able to find pathways that suits everyone, and it will lead to a more inclusive learning environment.